folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of RimWorld. We're in Alpha 13 still, in our town of Cougar's Hope, and just going through the notes since last episode, or actually the last couple of episodes, and, you know, we've had our little run-in with the sappers that, well, first time they came and hit right here, and we took them out as they entered. This time they took out a little bit bigger chunk, a little bit more powerful. Group came in, kidnapped one of our prisoners, let the rest of them go except for Hippo, and bled all over our map. But I was asking for ideas on how to deal with them, because we've pretty much got everything else dialed in. You know, people our gauntlets are working, and quite often, especially with sieges, they tend to hit down here, but siegers hardly ever get to the gauntlets before they've already been taken down. So we're kind of figuring that out. It's the sappers that have had the most success against us. So it's kind of interesting seeing the suggestions come in. I have to laugh. All the guff that President Trump has taken about suggesting building a wall on the U.S. southern border to keep terrorists from entering such a soft border with very few checks, that you know, everyone is making fun of him, but the majority of everyone said, build a wall, build a wall. So I thought that was kind of funny. But there is something to be said about that. I mean, there really is. Up here, we basically have walls. You know, walls are smart. And they're designed in a way for people to think that they're walking right in to an open base, but it's just loaded with traps. Same thing over here. These walls, though, have got no defense. The assumption is that attackers will almost always take an opening rather than butt their head against walls and try to, you know, eventually chisel their way through, except they bring frag grenades and they don't take that long before they're through. So this area does need some more defenses. I don't want to create defenses that will attract other enemies to these and skip this altogether. This is working. I don't want to break what isn't broken. So to design something down here as a fallback plan without attracting others that would like to see just an opening and you know, go for it. So what I'm thinking of, and I'm doing this all on pause because this is our next major event right here. Dwayne is going to get his robotic leg put in, but I want to talk about this first, then we'll get around to watching the events unfold over there. But if we did something like this and over, and this may not be the exact plan, but this is the idea I'm thinking of. A couple of turrets here and there. We could leave that door in place. Maybe there and there. Maybe one in the middle toward the outer wall. So if it goes boom, it doesn't take out the inner wall. Same thing here. They bust through, they're going to walk into live turret fire. In which case, we'll invite them to bust through. What are the suggestions? It was suggested that kind of what I had started, but I got there too late. If I had had rokes down here, maybe create a zone and restrict them to a zone that was just right there for a while with a bunch of blocks ready to go, and he could have gone through and just kept repairing back and forth as they were banging on it while we were getting into better positions to take them out from out here. So that was a possibility. Another one was mortars. Could have launched mortars out against them and gone boom. And there is something to be said about that, though what I was trying to keep them from doing was blowing up our wall to let the prisoners out. And so us blowing up our own wall would not have helped there, but in other places it probably would have worked fine. We could have closed down the security doors in the bedrooms over here and blown up them, you know, blown up the sappers out here with our mortars, and if we hit these walls and have to repair them, that'd be fine, because they're going to do the damage to them anyway. Just this one room was too sensitive to help them blow up the walls. But mortars, yeah, that's definitely a possibility too. And if we do build the outer wall like this, then we could attack this with them and just get them inside of the turrets that much faster. But with the turrets behind a wall, other raiders are not going to be attracted to the turret to attack it, which is what they want to do. They just go straight to a turret and bang their head against it and go boom. So since the turrets will not be available to them, only with frag grenades, they will take the gauntlet. So I think that is a good balance between the various suggestions. Were there any others? It was suggested we get rid of this one because it seems to be in our way no matter what we do to try to shoot, and it gives them cover. There's a valid point there. I was thinking of using this one to kind of box in this area and build our escape ship. But it doesn't have to be right here. Not really sure where. Easy access for us would be nice. Maybe it's right over here. Yeah, I can kind of see that. Kind of put a wall around this area and build an escape ship in there. We need gold. Have we discovered anything yet? Not really. Radar is out there trying. So that's what's up there. Another thing I wanted to show you before I got going, and I did an experiment and it worked. At least the results came out the way that it was suggested. Kerry Ulrich is watching this series, but is several episodes back from here and going through all the episodes and popped in a suggestion. I'm guessing, I haven't gone back to that episode, I think it was episode 38 that the suggestion came in on. I'm guessing it has something to do with the bugs that were infesting one of these bedrooms. I'm picturing this room right here. The infestations will happen if you mine into a mountain. Let's grab one that's a little more obvious. If you mine into here, this mountain right here, you see when we zoom out, the perimeter of it. But we're only seeing a two-dimensional plane cut out of the base of a three-dimensional mountain. So above this plane is the rest of this mountain. Below this plane is the ground, either of which bugs could chew their way through and pop into the room. That's why the idea that if there is a mountain roof over it, this says overhead mountain, and then they could be tunneling in and dropping into the room. So it was suggested that if we build constructed walls on the perimeter, let's see, where's another place? So if we were to just dig out a room and then put in constructed walls around it, kind of like Vapa's doing over in his map right now, then they can't come in from the walls. But if you were to, this room right here, rock thin roof over the top, and if we were to zone, expand no roof area, let's put no roof right there. Now there's no roof. Does it say outdoors? Click away, outdoors 54 degrees, it's called unroofed. Doesn't say outdoors though, but it says unroofed. 68 degrees, out here is 54 degrees. So it's unroofed, but it is still under the mountain. Okay. So now, in newer versions of the game, they'll have to come in and bust out that roof and deconstruct it. But this is Alpha 13, so it's instantly unroofed inside here. Then if you go back in, let me run the game for a second. And Brand just made it back to the comms console to see if Unbreak Interstellar would like to have these last little things that we've gathered up, like the steel club. This is a little pause right here. Just pretend this isn't happening. Limestone club. We kept the gladius and the spear. And another spear showed up, right? I thought we only kept one of each. Let's get rid of one and get rid of the limestone club. Oh, that's our leg now. I was going to say they have another one, but that's our leg now. Okay, that wasn't making sense. All right, so we can eke out another 81 silver out of them. That's why we said Bran to go talk to them one last time before they leave. Anyway, no, pause. So this is now. Why is it not saying? Oh, it's not saying because it is unroofed. So if we were to then zone and clear no roof area, unpause, you should see it's now constructing. Now in newer versions, they'll have to come over and do that manually. So if we pop out over here, it's now a constructed roof. Now that it is a constructed roof and constructed walls, except for I see one space over here, there's nowhere for the bugs to chew their way through to get in. Now, I don't know if we need to put a constructed floor over the top, like this guy. We didn't get into that in our conversation. But the idea is that infestations cannot happen now. That's the thought. So I've not run this through in any sense to prove whether or not that's actually a case. But that's the theory that I'm working on at the moment. So over time, I will do that process to the entire base. Don't necessarily have to do it on camera, but you kind of got the sense. Now, in Alpha 16, you're going to say no roof, and then they're going to come over here and work on the whole thing and get rid of the roof, and you're going to put it back in. They're going to come back and rebuild the whole roof again. So it's not as instantaneous as Alpha 13, where this is all just being played with. It wasn't really fully implemented yet. Anyway, that's what's up with that. Let me check my notes. See if there's anything else that was really important. So that one, I think that covers all of the notes that had come in, with the exception of Dwayne. Now, we were having a little conversation about whether or not he really wanted to go through putting on a $6 million man leg in order to restore his second right toe. It's a risk. Any operation is a risk. Dwayne, health. So his second right toe has been destroyed. But more importantly, character, he is a prosophile. Feels limited in his feeble human body. He often dreams of going bionic. So he's constantly battling. Well, it's not that big, but he's always got a -4. And as you can see, he's got enough negatives going on right now to where it's actually a little bit serious. Though, actually, he could use some food. Let's have him grab a fine meal first. You're not Dwayne. Let's get one less issue against him before we do all this. But I had jokingly said that, he's... because he's going to be fast now with his bionic leg, that he'll even be able to keep up with Cassie, who's got a 4.8 something walk speed, or run speed. And she rode in. It's kind of funny, because I was joking about keeping up with Cassie, and he called me Hodel of Fiddler on the Roof, matchmaking. And she rode in and said, "Well, I'll only consider him if he paints flames on his bionic leg, his robot leg, and if he outraces a starved charging grizzly bear." So Dwayne, you are our new bear hunter. We'll have some fun with you. We'll see what your run speed turns out to be, but I think we're going to go ahead and do this. You're bringing parts over, aren't you, Dwayne? Unrestricted health. He's still conscious. He's still able to say, "Heck with this, I'm out of here." But Rabbit went and got the bionic leg right there. Yep, he is on his way. Last chance, Dwayne. You better get out of the... No, okay. We're doing it. Oh, the blood It's just splotching and splashing. And so there is a critical failure worked built into the game that randomly could happen right now. It's rare, but I have seen it happen. And it's messy. Breakdown, battery. Whew, glad it wasn't a surgical breakdown. Boom. What do we got? He's anesthetized, so he's unconscious. Does it say that somewhere? His consciousness is very poor. He's got a bionic leg. Ooh. His run speed now is 0.5. He's out. Give him a while. He's a little dopey right now. We'll catch up with him later. So the thought is, I wondered about this door over here. I think we'll leave it. Interesting. They could use this path. What I'm thinking about is taking the bear door, or what I call the bear door, bring it down here, and running this the rest of the way through. What if we, structure, granite wall, did that and that? We could then get rid of this. This doesn't have to have another opening, right? Now think about that. I mean, if our people were to get in there and get trapped, run in and they run in after them, it'd be nice if they had a way out. Out to where? If this were the case, then this wouldn't really need to all be here, would it? Just that. I suppose so. Then we could just a regular steel door that. We're putting auto doors in there. Okay, I see. Granite wall to there. Steel door there. And cancel there. Okay. You guys can go into here and go in. It's not that necessary. I'm giving them a new way through to get out here. But then we'd also granite wall something like... That's it there? Yeah. Some of that to that. Kind of protecting these outer walls here. I guess the same thing here. I mean, sappers can come in from the side. Bust into our armory. Oh, that would be bad. Starvation. Ooh. Nettie. Gut worm. Oh, this has got to end soon. Needs your rest as good as it's going to get, because... You need to get something to eat. All right. Architect, granite wall. We've struck compact machinery. Actually, I want to click on that while the message is here. Good. And since we're out here playing in bear country, we probably should take kind of evaluate what we're up against here. What's going on? Bear down here next to all the deer. And he's apparently eaten this one. So let's unforbid that. We'll go down and pick him up. We'll get back to our wall in a second. Any other bears here? No. And no. So move over. One screen. Pop down. And just the guy... The bear sleeping in the deer. He's there. Oops. Can't quite get to that edge. We can look at him. Fine. Her. Oh, it's dark. It's hard to see these things in the dark. Another her. Going to eat probably by the end of the episode. Ah, here's someone who's a little bit closer in. Maybe Dwayne will play with him. Her. They're all hers. Okay, working our way up. All the way to the top. Any new cougars? No. Alright, and here. One last pass. Not seeing anything. Well, it's dark and it's rain. It's even more difficult to spot these. And I've got an extra light in here that's reflecting on my screen. Ah, much better. Dwayne is no longer capable of walking. And he's got a really poor mood right now. Alright, what's up? You are on your way up. Because... Oh, you're a night owl at night. That helps. You like being up at night. 14. positive, has a bionic body part. Woo. Minus 4 to a positive 14, that's an 18 point swing. Wow, I'm liking that. Very comfortable. What? Oh, everybody has got a bonus. This colony buried someone in an automated sarcophagus. May his soul rest in peace. Wow. So by burying Ronnie properly, everybody's happy. Had a fine meal. Moderate expectations. All right, this is looking good. We'll get some more food, and you'll be fine. You did get a meal before, right? You didn't just head over there, then change your mind and get back in bed? Because that seems like they went down awfully fast. Still got the gut worm, though. It may have something to do with it. I wonder if they're eating twice a day. I never noticed that. And we just fed Nettie. She's gone back to bed. And she's already half gone on her food. Interesting. They may be making or eating two or three meals a day. All right, so they're... I think we established there are no bears to worry about. We didn't see this area up here. Anything new walk into the map? No. So none of the bears were going to eat, at least the beginning of this episode. I am thinking about... Let's see here. Let's... You are granite. Should we switch this up besides granite? We're having a hard time finding enough of it. I kind of think so. What is our choice? This is marble, which I think is pretty weak. 450 in hit points. Natural granite, sandstone. Okay, well, sandstone is 400. That's even worse. And granite. Find me a granite. Down here was granite. 900. Yeah, it's a huge difference. We gotta just mine through all this stuff until we get enough extra blocks to make it happen, but this needs to be granite. So, in that case, I'm just trying to rethink things here. It's gotta be granite. Something like this. All the way to there. Well, I do like the clipping off the corner here, just to make it easier to walk past it. Yeah, we'll do that. For that matter, we could probably do that here too. Yeah, that'd be fine. Starvation still. Rokes. He's taking care of it. Okay. And so, these won't need to be here. That won't need to be here. Door could go into there. Steel, just a steel door. Don't have to auto-door it. These could all go away. So we can enter from here. We can enter... How would you do this one? I mean, we could just clip it off and just leave this one little area exposed, but that seems... like, not a great idea. And we do want to probably do that. Just to give them time to bust through one before they get into the next one. Is that... That's sandstone. Okay. And then a security. A turret waiting inside to say hello. Suppose we would need a door in there just... Not necessarily. We could build everything and then fill in the gap and never really see it again. Although turrets do break down. Yeah, they do. Okay. Structure, steel door. Right there. Steel door here. Security. Turret. There. There, there. Shoot in two directions at least. At any point. There should get into this and down the length here, and that will assist going this way, and one in the middle. Okay. Let's exhume these graves. Now, was there a way to do that quick and easy. Now, if I were to destroy the grave, I'm pretty sure it'll kick out the body, and we'll have to do it in two steps. Is that right? Let's find out. X. Let's see what happens. Okay. Let's see what Cassie does. Never mind. we were visiting the grave, weren't we? Okay. Hey, we gotta finish this too, but let's continue this idea. All right. Call this one done. It's going to take them a long time to build this, so give me your thoughts in the comments about what you think about all this. Exhume these, burn, you know, cremate the bodies, extra wall. Same thing here. What do we do here? Picture the two doors that are in. Is there a reason to do the two doors now? There probably is. I mean, the only weak spot is right here. They bust through here, they got to go through this wall, then they got to go through this wall to get in. Same thing as if there were double walls there. Yeah, I think so. So let's mine these out. We'll put into the door right there for hunting bear. Speaking of that one bear, he was nearby. Where was he? He was closer than I was comfortable with. Don't know if that's the one. He might have been. Klaus is mining these out. Great. We've been concentrating down here. You. So, where's that other one I just had? Thought he was further up. No, maybe not. We'll ignore the bears for just now. Okay. So, if we build the ship over here, this wall does not need to be there. Question, though, along with these walls being put in, sappers want to attack our property. If we built this one here, they're probably going to attack this too. And or instead, do we pop any walls out and about to give them targets other than our base? There's that thought. I know one thing I want to do. Let me see here. Where did Dwayne go? I don't see a little Dwayne running around in here. Let's find him this way. Ah, because he's sound asleep. He's got a run speed now of 5.07. Whoa! Alright, Cassie. He can chase you down now. You were the fastest. 5.07. Wow. I haven't seen that since they had the sensory mechanitis, I think it was called. And then they had 6-point-something run speeds. So, yeah, he would be very capable of taking out a grizzly now. Wouldn't even need the bear door. But let's put one in for others who may need that structure. Steel door. Four spaces? Okay, well, we'll go... go there. Now, there is a stockpile over here that's no good anymore. So let's kill the stockpile. Another stockpile here. Kill that one. Okay, I think it's it on the stockpiles. Let's set all of these to haul. And sandstone, haul. And let's see. Let's build another... well, do this way. Another dumping stockpile. We just struck jade. I can't even say it. Okay, let's grab those while I can find them. Grab that little area there. And there's a little void right here, so we're going to get a message here real soon that we've found a compartment or a space. Jump two, they've already fixed it. These are on, these are off. That one had a problem, but we're starting to overwhelm our batteries a little bit. What time of day is it? One. Wow. Flash storm. Violent thunder, lightning strikes all around. Zoom out. I've always wondered if these flash storms, if they just strike in a cluster and just the cluster moves, or if it truly is random all over the map. We're hitting over here. That's considered home zone. They're going to go out and try to put that out. Vapa's probably got the order. Boom. And they can get struck by lightning. It'd be a good idea not to let them go out. This is a flash storm. It doesn't involve rain. So it's not putting itself out. Wow. Vapa, I think maybe you ought to sit this one out. She hit over there. Let's let this thing get over with. Manuel, you are cremating. Whoa! It's impressive from out here. Yeah, bird's eye view of a lightning storm. Area revealed. That was down there somewhere. Dwayne is going for a walk in a flash storm. Of course. Yeah, I'm a little uncomfortable about that too. I'll send you over here with Vapa. Let these fires do their thing, then we'll go put them out. Now, what was I talking about before this happened? Whoa. Flash storm is over. Ah, okay. So, flash storm. Extreme amounts of lightning are hitting a small region. This can cause massive fires. Okay. And area revealed. Jump to that little void right there. Alright, that's fine. So, that's all done. And let's not only release Vapa and Dwayne, but let's get these fires out while we still have some trees over here. And let's see, zone, expand home zone into here for now. Yeah, go ahead and get those fires out, guys. Otherwise, what was I doing? I was in the middle of a sentence when that hit. Where was I? We're talking about here. I was wanting to grab, let's see, put in a dump stockpile. How so? Like that? I want to put these guys out to slow a bear down while whoever's using this gets through the door. So there and there. Of course, it makes whoever uses the door run really slow through them too. So it goes wrong both ways. But I think it'll work. Let's grab... This is all... slag. So let's find this stockpile, copy settings, and paste into there and paste into there. Okay. Mad animal. Who we got? A local squirrel. Seems odd to get that this late in the game. You are a manhunter. Of course, I laugh, and then, you know, you've seen what the killer bunnies can do. So, we're going after Klaus. Klaus has a charge rifle. Klaus, draft you go to here. Let's head this guy off, and you're instantly taking aim. Three shots. Boom, boom, boom. Got him. Good shot. You're undrafted, and you are unforbidden. And you are granite. Woohoo! Yes, thank you. Bear needs. You're fine. Alright, so bear door is in. Eventually, stones are going to go back in to slow the bear down. That one bear I was concerned about, who was starting to get hungry, was not that one. That's a turtle. Speaking of, it's something else I want to do. I know we've been taming the turtles and kind of building up our humorous turtle death squad, but turtles would make a great target for colonists needing to skill up their shooting skills. They take forever shooting them constantly. The shells offer such great protection. Dwayne, come on down here. Let's end this episode with you taking on a grizzly bear with no cover. Because I think you're that good. But you're over here. We do have a little bit of an issue over here. Yeah. I expect rain soon, though. I assume Dwayne's in here. I'm not seeing a... There you are. Oh, no! And I didn't get in here to seal up the rooms yet. Where are you? A bug hive has emerged. I don't want to click on it because I'd like to be able to have it for next episode. Just curious if it's obvious where they are. Here, I thought I was going bear hunting. Tell me you're not in the base. So far, I don't see them. This was the bug defense. This was the reason from the very beginning for taming boomalopes. We've got walking landmines in here. Interesting. Very interesting. Well, Cassie, you're just going to have to wait now. Remind me later to watch the Dwayne... how did you put it? Wish I had that on my other screen there. Anyway, basically racing and winning a starved charging grizzly bear. That's going to have to wait because by the time I get that done, it'll be too late for here. This needs to be turned on. Designate toggle power. We're going to take this guy down to crazy low temperatures and let it run. I don't expect it's going to be enough. What I expect is going to happen is that we're going to have to shoot the boomalopes. This thing's going to light on fire and build up enough heat to kill everything in here, including the infestation. That's most likely what's going to happen. Though I am curious to see what would happen here instead. In fact, I'll wait till next episode. What I'm thinking of is rezoning the boomalopes and getting them out of here and letting this run for a while. We're pretty much, except for the door, we're double-walled everywhere. So it's going to take them a little while to get out. Do we still have that lance? That, can't think of what it was called now. Thought we'd bought a second one. This one. So we still have this insanity lance. One use. Drives any character into berserk state from any distance, even through walls. This is what we did when we had the infestation over here. The one started to chip through and I used the lance on him. He went berserk. They all killed him. And that gave us a pause before anything else started to chip through. So we could use that on one to protect this weak spot right here. Otherwise, now one cooler is going to take a long time to get that temperature down. But I have been told, I haven't seen it personally, that chilling them will eventually freeze them to death. In which case, we save our boomalopes. I'd rather save the boomalopes to run them into a room and, you know, use them as portable bug bombs rather than lose them all right here when we do have a secondary defense system. Okay, we're going to pause that one right here. I'm trying to get all of my series into at least slightly shorter episodes. The 1 hour episodes take a long time to edit and render and upload and process. So shorter episodes, if I can get down to the 30 minute range, I can get a lot more of them out. I used to do 2 or 3 videos a day for 2 or 3 series a day, every day. But they were considerably shorter episodes. That was the only way I could do that. Can't do it anymore. So this, there's lots going on. We'll finish this up next time. So thanks, folks, for watching. Appreciate it. Hit the subscribe and the like if you would, and I'll catch you next time, folks. Bye bye.